During the Moneyline 300 a few weeks ago, Tyler Reddick certainly cashed in with his excellent performance at the Talladega Super Speedway. He drove like an absolute stud throughout the duration, coming back from a speeding penalty and right side damage after a collision with the wall. A few bold moves and blocks later, the 23-year-old hoisted the hardware with new boss Richard Childress. The defending champion has emerged as a star over the past few seasons and has the car in driving position with a hot start. With that said, before we hit the gas pedal on this new upload, don't forget to like the video, subscribe, and hit the bell icon so that you never miss new content. Prove the haters that you are a legitimate YouTube commenter, and getting instant notifications can help you cross that checkered flag in that aspect. The journey through the glorious garages of NASCAR started in 2014 as Brad Keselowski saw some promise in the California kid. After a part-time 16-race campaign, Reddick got his big break by piloting the 19 Ford F-150 for the Truck Series Championship. For his rookie season, he did a great job trucking along and producing consistent results on the racetrack. He took home two checkered flags during the season opener at Daytona as well as Dover and netted 14 top fives and 19 top 10 finishes. In spite of these statistics, Erik Jones and KBM were a notch ahead of the 19 truck and they finished second in the NASCAR Truck Series standings. Don't worry, next season will be the year Reddick gets on top. Despite the prowess of a full schedule under his belt, the infamous sophomore slump saw the renumbered 29 team fall into mediocrity. The team featured very erratic results, which led to Tyler Reddick missing the playoffs. Ironically, he scored a win at Las Vegas, which would salvage an otherwise underwhelming season. Bad Brad ultimately cut Reddick after a faltering season, which left him a free agent for only 8 days. Chip Ganassi immediately swooped up the young star under his wing and gave him a part-time ride in the NASCAR Xfinity Series. This wasn't just any part-time team, however, as the 42 Camaro was among the fastest and most dominant teams in the series. Carr won 3 races between both Kyle Larson and Justin Marks, and with sponsorship from Broken Bow Records, Reddick's NASCAR career was in good health. He backed this up with a star performance at Kentucky as the horsepower under the hood helped him win his first NASCAR Xfinity race. His 66 circuits out front as well as a staggering 15-second margin of victory churned out a bluegrass-style victory, yielding back to the early days of the sport. This triumph caught the eye of the sport's most popular driver, Dale Earnhardt Jr., as he was signed to replace William Byron in the championship-winning number 19. Davey Lenz would crew chief this BurgerFi Chevrolet, and the duo were hoping to serve up wins and success like its fast food counterpart. And for the most part, their appetite was tamed by winning the Daytona 300, edging out teammate Elliott Sadler in a close finish. This was absolutely followed by 6 months of underwhelming finishes and inconsistencies on the results chart. The 9 team limped into the playoffs with only 5 top 5s and 5 DNFs. It was almost destiny for this team to go in and out of the postseason in record time. Once the playoffs started, however, the 9 bunch stepped up their game and started consistently putting together results. Tyler Reddick scored 1 top 5 and 6 top 10 finishes through the first 2 playoff rounds and advanced to the championship race in Homestead, Miami. It was a great first season for Tyler Reddick, and he will be a force to be reckoned with next year with his growing experience. As for this year, expect a drubbing from Christopher Bell. I mean, you guys seriously think Tyler Reddick has a shot at this championship? That's hilarious. He is going to get single-handedly pounded by that 20 team. This is where Tyler Reddick comes up clutch, as his ability to ride the wall leads to him leading 44 circuits in clean air. As the checkers fell on the Xfinity season, an unlikely face completed an improbable run to the 2018 championship. To many of NASCAR's faithful, however, Tyler Reddick was deemed not my champion. And once again, cries were unleashed to bring back the traditional points format. Luck, they say, led him to the throne of the Xfinity Series, and NASCAR's already divided fan base found itself spread apart once again. While I question his title legitimacy at first, you have to give credit where credit is due. Reddick got red hot when it mattered the most and had the consistency that the top dogs lacked throughout the playoffs. Not to mention Christopher Bell had the lead with 37 laps left and completely faded away during the final run. Championship teams close out races, which was something Jason Ratcliffe and the 20 team failed to do when it mattered. Despite your stance on the playoff format, this is the new way a champion is crowned. And Tyler Reddick jumped on that opportunity where others faltered. You cannot deny that in any shape or form. Even with the hard work, Tyler Reddick would not return to Junior Motorsports in 2019. He remained in the Chevrolet band for the third straight season, but this time shifting his talents to Richard Childress Racing. He felt like this was his best opportunity to get a cup ride, and the newly downsized single full-time organization would field the two car in the Xfinity Series with Randall Burnett on top of the pit box. So when this move was first made public, I didn't expect anything major from Tyler Reddick. While the 21 car itself was strong in RCR stable, it didn't seem like a winning move that would make them championship contenders. A string of top 5s and top 10s were expected, but nothing remotely close to the performance of Christopher Bell or Justin Allgaier. With that said, the two team has reached the pinnacle of success after the first 9 Xfinity races, as Tyler Reddick's talent and momentum from the season championship has taken the organization to new heights, and his statistics have been incredible to start the season. One win at Talladega, 8 top 5 finishes, including 7 in a row dating back to ISM, 9 top 10 finishes, and an average finish of 4.7. Not to mention his worst finish of the season, 14th at Las Vegas, but that event was a spectacular one for the California native. He was swapping paint with Kyle Busch in the Sin City and led 62 laps out front before a late race mistake ended a promising run. We've also seen Reddick get baptized into the NASCAR Cup Series, as for the most part, he has been blessed with fast race cars and great finishes. He was able to race into the Daytona 500, and had he avoided a few crashes and issues, possibly a top 15 finish would have been in the cards. Meanwhile, he was able to tame a top 10 finish at Kansas Speedway, and he outperformed both full-time teammates Austin Dillon and Daniel Hemric. At one point, he was even battling for the lead position in just his sophomore start. This was certainly a surprise, especially considering the 31 team doesn't run the full schedule, as his head crew chief doesn't have the notes or experience compared to the number 3 and 8 teams. It truly shows Tyler Reddick is a wheel man and he can perform with decent equipment. Definitely an exciting driver to watch. So as for my commentary, he carries on his shoulders a bold, aggressive racing style to the track, and he reminds me of his former boss, Brad Keselowski. Obviously, Brad seized the golden opportunity at Junior Motorsports, and it caught the eye of NASCAR's captain, Roger Penske. Now, sure, he struggled during the early part of his Grand National career, and he had a horrid first-time cup campaign in 2010. Regardless of the results, Bad Brad worked hard every day in the garage, and he showcased his talents and aggressive nature when the stage shined the brightest. Because of that will to perform in the Grand National Division, just look at the major league accomplishments today. 29 career wins, 106 top 5 finishes, and a 2012 championship carry a heavyweight for the Rochester Hills, Michigan native. And you have to keep in mind, this was a game-changing driver when he joined the Captain's Empire. This could be the case with Reddick at RCR, as his ability to work hard and perform on the pavement could be the missing puzzle to the team's success. Now, don't get me wrong, Austin Dillon and Daniel Hemric are good quality drivers, and not to forget two-time stage winner Ty Dillon under the organization's umbrella. While they combined for 1 championship and 3 wins as Xfinity regulars, they lack the wheel power we've seen with Tyler Reddick in recent memory. They haven't taken that top 15 car and put it into the top 10 and build further on an already stable race team. Tyler Reddick already has more top 5s in that 2 car than Matt Tift the season prior, and has transformed that team into a solid favorite for the title. His audition last weekend also shows he can make RCR equipment a force to be reckoned with, and compete on intermediate tracks which have been a weakness since the mid-2010s. He has proven he can construct a skyscraping result on the scoreboard, which is needed to move a driver and organization upwards. As we take the final lap, Tyler Reddick is a prospect to keep your eye on. He's climbed the ladder throughout the highs and lows, and is today wheeling at the top of his game on a consistent squad. He is arguably a top five prospect right now, combining trucks and Xfinity, and Richard Childress should be considering a cup entry for Reddick sooner than later. Whether it's the misfortunate 31 car or an ECR satellite entry, his presence could be a game changer for an organization mired in mediocrity since the departure of Kevin Harvick. Hopefully Reddick can claim his second championship in Xfinity as well, not only to prove he's ready for cup, but to shut up the haters. Prove that the kid from Corning, California is no fluke act, and that he is a legitimate prospect for the future. So anyways, this is NRF signing out, and just remember, life's a beach, and then you drive.